Hello students, good morning to all of you. Hope you are reading well and you are not wasting your time in your home. Okay, today we will have one more session, that is minor ailments of pregnancy. Okay. Minor ailments during pregnancy. Minor ailments, these are very minor problems, but they may be disturbing to the mother a lot. They doesn't require any treatment or any doctor attention, but with simple measures they can be reduced. See, during pregnancy, due to hormones like estrogen, progesterone and prolactin, they increase in the blood. To this increase in the hormones is responsible for the growth of the baby, so that these hormones provide an environment in the womb of the mother for the baby's growth. At the same time, these hormones may cause a lot of discomfort to the mother, especially human chorionic gonadotropin. It causes nausea and vomiting. So let us see what are the definition of minor ailments. The minor ailments of pregnant women that occur due to physiological alterations of hormones and other causative factors which can be managed without medical interventions. Then minor ailments, what are the minor ailments during pregnancy? First is the nausea and vomiting. The women may face nausea and vomiting, especially in the morning, and are usually very common in primary gravida. They usually appear following the first or second missed period and subside by the end of the first trimester. But in some people, this nausea and vomiting may persist even after the completion of the second trimester. Some of the women, they may have excessive nausea and vomiting. We call it as hyperemesis gravidarum. In such case, may require administration of intravenous fluids and to correct electrolyte fluid and electrolyte imbalances. Now, what is the treatment for nausea and vomiting? Very small frequent meals must be given to the mother, like every 2 hours, instead of giving large meals, and something sweet to drink to the mother before going to bed in the night, and also after immediately after getting up in the morning. Avoidance of excessive foods which cause offense, which have odor or offensive odor, and restriction of fried foods. These are the measures which can reduce nausea and vomiting. Next is the backache. It is common problem in pregnancy, and due to physiological changes that contribute to backache in the mother or weight gain, hyperlordosis, where if the mother wears high heel shoes, due to muscular spasm and also urinary tract infections and constipation. These are all the changes that can cause backache in the mother. Now, what is the treatment for this backache? Excessive weight gain should be avoided, and massage of back muscles, adequate rest should be given to the mother, and elevation of the legs to flex the hips, and also some sort of antenatal exercises also will help to reduce backache. Next one is the constipation. It is a quite common ailment during pregnancy. Due to atonicity of the gut, due to the effect of progesterone and diminished physical activity and pressure of the gravid uterus on the pelvic colon, may cause constipation. The treatment measures are intake of higher foods like whole grains, cereals and breads, brown rice, fresh foods, and intake of at least 10 to 12 glasses of fluids every day in the form of water is sufficient. Next is the leg cramps. Leg cramps are common during pregnancy. It may be due to deficiency of diffusible serum calcium or elevation of serum phosphorus. Weight gain during pregnancy. All these may cause leg cramps and pains in the mother. The measures to reduce leg cramps are avoiding standing or sitting with legs crossed for long periods of time, and massaging the legs and application of local heat may be effective, and also some antenatal exercises also will be effective. Regarding antenatal exercises and all, we will see in antenatal care. Next is the heartburn. This is very common in pregnancy due to relaxation of the esophageal sphincter, and many women experience heartburn for the first time during pregnancy. The treatment measures are avoiding overeating and advise the mother not to go to bed immediately after the meal, so that the mother have to take the meals before 7 p.m. in the evening, and she may go to bed at 9 p.m. And using of liquid antacids and elevation of head of the bed will be helpful in reducing the heartburn and acidity in the mother. And next is the varicose veins. These varicose veins in the legs and vulva or rectum may appear for the first time or aggravate during pregnancy, usually in the later months. It is due to obstruction of the venous return by the pregnant uterus, growing uterus. See, sometimes these varicose veins may prolapse in the rectum area in the form of hemorrhoids. The measures to reduce these varicose veins are crepe bandage during movement. When the mother moves, she has to wear a crepe bandage, and elevation of the limbs during rest or regular antenatal exercise for prevention of varicose veins. Next is the hemorrhoids. Hemorrhoids may cause unknown complications like bleeding or may get prolapsed. And regular use of laxative to keep the bowel soft, local application of hydrocortisone ointment and replacement of piles if they are prolapsed. These are very sufficient. And also using of high fiber diet may also reduce hemorrhoids. And next is the vaginal discharge. These vaginal discharge or vaginal secretions is very common during pregnancy because there is changing of vaginal pH due to conception or due to hormones. And if at all the mother is having foul smelling or unpleasant vaginal discharge, then immediately she has to seek the advice of the doctor. Normally this discharge will be clear and white in color without any unpleasant smell. And measures are, assurance should be given to the patient and also to the patient attenders, and advice for local cleanliness or which are required. And then presence of any infection should be treated with application of vaginal metronidazole or miconazole. If at all that is not sufficient, then the mother may have to go to doctor for treatment. Next, okay. So these are the minor minor ailments which can be seen in the mother. See girls, these ailments are very common in case of primi gravida. But in some of the women, even second, third trimester also, they may have these minor disorders. Okay girls, if you have any doubts, you can just go through the book. You can easily understand just by reading once. If you want detailed, then whenever you come to college in theory classes, we will have in detail discussion. Okay, thank you girls. Have a nice time.